Good evening, class 11. How is my class? Going good? Enjoying accountancy? How are your spirits in accountancy? I hope you're enjoying, girls. I never get any responses from you, any queries from you. Should I understand that you're understanding everything? Or I should assume that nothing is getting registered? Either all clear or all clear. What is the status? How is accountancy proceeding? Please keep giving little feedback. Please keep posting little feedback. Are you happy? Are you not? Are there queries? They are not. Are you satisfied? Are you understanding? So that I also get a feedback and I can try some other way which suits you. Unless I am able to make you satisfied, unless I am able to satisfy you, my purpose is not solved. So keep me posted, keep me a little updated so that I come to know how is the understanding status, how are you following it or not. It's a new subject for you. So take it gradually, take it pleasantly and we'll manage, we'll rush. Isn't it? We'll cope up, don't worry. Anyway, chalo girls, now we proceed with the diminishing balance method today. The diminishing balance method, we had depreciation. Yes, this is depreciation. I had started with diminishing balance method the day before yesterday. On Saturday, we had discussed diminishing balance method, also called return on value method or reducing value method. Children, in this method, other than the original cost, this is a little departed from the original cost, from the fixed installment method, where with the book value, the depreciation also goes on reducing. That is why it is also called reducing balance method, reducing value method, because the value of depreciation is also reducing year by year. How is it reducing? Because if 10,000 was the initial value when the asset was acquired, suppose it depreciates at 10%. The depreciation in the first year will be 10% of 10,000, that is rupees 1,000. And the book value after this year, at the end of the first year, or we can say in the beginning of the second year, it will come to 10,000 minus this depreciation, that is 9,000. Now here is the little departure from the fixed installment method, or little catch here, that now 10% to be charged as depreciation in the second year will not be 10% of the book value. It will be 10% of the value reduced in that year. So reduced value is, the diminished value is, or the return on value is rupees 9,000. So 10% in the second year on 9,000. Reduce this balance, it will come to 8,100. Next, third year, this year 10% to be charged as depreciation, but 10% of 8,100, that is 810. Then 10% of the reduced value, then 10% of the reduced value, and it goes on. That is how depreciation also goes on reducing each year, to be called it as the reducing value method. The depreciation also is reducing, the diminishing balance method, right? Now, I'm proceeding with this, girls. Just wait.